Welcome back to another episode of Earth from Space. Part of the Frisian Islands, a low-lying archipelago just off the coast of northern Europe, is visible in this image captured by Copernicus Sentinel-2. The Frisian Islands stretch from the northwest of the Netherlands through Germany to the west of Denmark. Although they're considered a single physical feature, they're divided into West, East, and North Frisian Islands, with the North Frisian Islands visible here. The islands are split between Germany and Denmark. There are four larger islands that make up the archipelago. These are Sylt, Föhr, Amrum, and Pelvum. Sylt, the largest of the archipelago, is around 100 square kilometers and is known for its distinctive shape of its shoreline. The island extends more than 35 kilometers in length, and in some places is only 1 kilometer wide. A sandy beach stretches across the island's west coast, however it has begun to erode owing to storm tides. The northernmost island of Germany, it is connected to the mainland by the Hindenburg Dam, an 11 kilometer long causeway. The Wadden Sea on the island's east side is part of the Schleswig-Holstein-Wadden Sea National Park and has been a nature reserve and bird sanctuary since 1935. The island of Föhr is called the Green Island due to it being sheltered from the storms of the North Sea by its neighboring islands. The island of Amrum features an extended beach area along its west coast, which faces the open North Sea. The east coast borders to mudflats and tidal creeks of the Wadden Sea. The three white islands are the North Frisian Barrier Islands. These sandbanks, or shoals, act as a natural breakwater for the smaller islands closer to land. Just east of these lies the island of Pelvum. North of the Frisian Islands lie the Danish islands of Romu, Manu, and lastly, Fenu. In the top left, a large algal bloom is visible in emerald green. Harmful algal blooms caused by excessive growth of marine algae have occurred in the North Sea in recent years, with satellite data being used to track their growth and spread. These data can then be used to help develop alert systems to mitigate against damaging impacts for tourism and fishing industries.
Thank you.